come to the Blacksburg community and kind of what he envisions with regard to bringing holistic wellness to a wider audience. Thank you, Ferris. I'll turn the floor over to you.
Yeah, thank you. I really appreciate Robert. Thank you so much, and I appreciate Cody. So first of all, I speak four languages, and my original language is Arabic, in addition to Swahili and French. So I have more actually French accent because that's my school, till high school. So forgive me if you don't get my accent, just tell me speak slowly, or I can repeat that. So thank you so much for giving me this opportunity. I've been here in Blacksburg for the last 5 years, and CRC I've been for the last 2 years. And I explored Blacksburg the first time when I came from Oman. I'm coming from Oman, Middle East, which is the first Arab country to have diplomatic relation with the U.S. You can Google that. My plan was to go to California, but then I fell in love to this place. And when my son, Kais, he joined Virginia Tech, and he graduated from Virginia Tech as summa cum laude, is now with Microsoft. And my other son joined, Sammy joined the public college this year. So we are a very happy family to be blessed to be here in Blacksburg, So I feel that this is itself. I just do everything by presentation, by slide. Great. Oh, can you see the slides? Can you see the slides? Okay. I think I need to do the share. I'm sorry about that.
Yeah,
okay,
share.
Yeah, yeah, share screen. Yeah, I missed that one. I'm sorry about that. Okay. Well, Haqua wellness. The slide is the project. There it is. Oh, great. So, slideshow from beginning. Great. Great. Yeah, so I'm the founder of Haqua Wellness. And the motto of about our Haqua Wellness, actually, we are an establishment that promotes holistic health and wellness through the provision of Haqua Revitalize. So we don't treat diseases, actually, we revitalize. Revitalize therapeutic modalities and other professional services aimed at revitalizing and energizing the human body back to its state of physical, emotional, mental, and spiritual being through the body, mind, and spirit. And just as about myself, I'm a holistic health and wellness professional. In addition to my alternative medicine, a PhD from India, I'm a certified integrative health coach from Institute for Integrative Nutrition in New York, 2019. In addition, as an entrepreneur, a researcher, and author for 3 books. We just launched another recently a new book. And I'm in addition to founder of Haqua Revitalized Therapy. So we believe this is part of the haquapathic medicine that we believe is added side by side with the osteopathic medicine, because we believe the osteopathic is one side, the system, and haquapathic medicine is the fuel. So the system with the fuel put together. So we believe that we believe the missing part in the health care industry of holistic health and wellness. So just a glimpse about what we have done for the last, since we started this Haqua Revitalized Therapy. We so far conducted for the last 13 years, 65 lectures in universities and so on, colleges, schools, hospitals, health organizations, places of worships. And we've been in 33 media interviews in different countries, here in the United States, in the UK, Australia, and different places, and covering different parts of the, TV, radio interviews, and so on. And we've been speaking at 8 international conferences, including in California, San Diego, in Australia, and other countries, in the Middle East, and so on, the Philippines, and with different positions with the conferences. And so far, we collected 500 anecdotal evidences, mostly from the Middle East, because that's where I spend most of the time doing all these conferences, lectures, and everything, sharing the new discovery, what we believe, how could that impact the healthcare of human being. And I'm the first recipient of that, where I was diagnosed by the medical committee with the chronic diseases. My wife, Gloria, who is with me here, she helped me a lot. She was a nurse, 27 years in her career. And I could say she's my angel, because she rescued me several times when I collapsed and I was about to die. I was seeing death in front of me. So when I discovered this therapy and I was proclaimed asymptomatic for the last 10 years, and since until today I'm living with that, me and my family and many followers. So far we collected this anecdotal evidence. And we have four clinical trials that have been conducted in Algeria by Université des Frères Mentouri. It's a French university in Algeria. Recently we received one about COVID with vitamin, hot water with vitamin C. They found that there's, some good result in rats that destroy the viruses that caused by the COVID 2019. And we published four articles, scientific articles. So what we try to say here, when we look here at the system and the fuel, like you said, osteopathic medicine about the tenets of osteopathy and so on, is the system actually. But something was missing there about the body, how it can fix itself by itself. When you look carefully, everything, for example, if you take any machine or a vehicle and so on, the machine needs fuel to run. So if that machine, take an example, a vehicle, you have the engine oil, power steering fluid, engine oil coolant, transmission, all these. If the vehicle, irrespective of the brand or the price and so on, if you do not conduct a regular maintenance by professional, you will lose that vehicle. I mean, it's going to be very costly to maintain. And in addition to that, if you the vehicle run out of only just one of the fuel, for example, engine oil or coolant, then you cannot run that vehicle. Impossible. So on with a human being. A human being is completely different. A human being, it has its own natural fuels. It runs its... So the mechanism of the human body, based on the tenets of osteopathy about the body's innate ability to self-healing, self-maintenance, self-protection, but the system collapses the moment it's depleted with a minimal amount of the fuels. And these fuels, based on our research, formulated with the... infiltrated in the womb of a mother at the time when the fetal development takes place. And these, we coined them the human's fuels, or the fields. The fields denote the four essential elements of life. So particularly, exclusively, is the water, oxygen, hydrogen, energy. So if the human being runs out of these fuels, natural fuels, then something wrong. We coin it as a disease or abnormal function of the body. It could be in the physical part, emotional, or mental, or spiritual. Well, if you look carefully with the notable scientists, notable people, like, for example, Thomas Edison, he's been talking about in his quote about the doctor of the future will not use medicine, but only in the care of human, in the frame of human healthcare and in diet and in the cause and prevention of disease. According to American Osteopathic Association, is that the human body as a whole, as a complete system, and it runs based on the relationship between the body's nerves, muscles, bones, and organs. And it has its own innate ability to heal itself. But what we believe is that, based on our perception, is the fields, the four essential elements of life, that just capable to revive and energize as well, depends in its healing potential. So when you mean here, PEMS is just an abbreviation of the physical, emotional, mental, and spiritual. So according to American Holistic Health Association, that the entire system, the physical, emotional, mental, and spiritual, if one collapses, they're all interrelated together as a holistic health. But if one part collapses, then the entire system collapses. You know, stress can cause, for example, blood sugar to raise and so on. I mean, whereas a diabetes could be, it's falling under the physical part. So all these are interrelated as one part, completely together. If one part collapses, then its entire system may collapse. What we found is that the system itself collapses because when it runs out of these fuels, which you mentioned here, the water, oxygen, hydrogen, energy, particularly, exclusively, and it's coming from one source, hot water. Not cold, not warm, not iced, not boiled. Just exactly that temperature, what we mentioned, we'll come to that. So when you look at carefully between the left and the right side, so we believe that the discovery of osteopathic medicine, which was founded by Andrew Taylor Steele, he was a medical doctor, he was a scientist, and he went through a painful moment, so no pain, no gain. So sometimes we don't like the pain we're going through, but that pain can sometimes bring you opportunity. So when he went through pain, that's why he founded the first College of Osteopathic Medicine. And based on the tenet here, the body has its own innate ability to self-regulation, self-healing, self-maintenance. But what we believe, when I went through these complications, chronic complications, four chronic ailments, and my doctor was saying, my physician, first, you have to live with medication throughout your life. I didn't want to accept that because I have a childhood phobia, because my mother underwent 10 surgical operations in her stomach. So we were never raised by our parents. We were divided by to be raised by our uncles, two families. The reason is that our mother has to undergo surgery every 2 to 3 years. So that was my wish from childhood, that when I grow older, to discover something natural that can heal my mother and heal the world. And I never know that the universe will respond to that way. So we found that these fuels, they are forming exclusively a part of the system, entire system. And these fuels are not man-made. They are not created by man. They are not fabricated. It's there. It's free for everybody. I mean, that's where we came from. So why particularly Haqua? Actually, the name Haqua is coined as hot aqua. So aqua is a water. I mean, it's a Latin word of water. So put together as a brand is a Haqua. So that's just a abbreviation of meaning to say hot water. So we say Haquate more than to say hydrate. But carefully, when you look at every human being, you can never exempt your name. Please give me any person who has not gone through the fetal development and who has not gone through the amniotic fluid surrounded. And what is amniotic fluid? Exclusively. And if I'm wrong, please take a note. You can ask me questions. You can say, Ferris, you are wrong. Life is a school that has an endless process of learning. Every day we learn, we learn, we learn. So we will learn through questions, so this is where you are. This is where you were during the fetal development. No exception. So the amniotic fluid, scientifically, biologically, it's known to be composed of 99% water. The temperature is hot, it's not cold, it's not warm, it's hot at 37.5 degrees Celsius, which is 1 degree higher than the normal mother's temperature. And so we believe that the hot water, Haqua, is the source, exclusive source of creation and growth of every human being. There is not any exemption, except the first family ever. I don't know who you call them. You call them Adam and Eve, you're going to give them a different name. I mean, the first family, that's what's going to be different. But I mean, every human being has gone through that. So with the basic function of the Haqua revitalize, it destroys harmful bacteria, melt the fat deposit, but of course there's more to explain about the melting fat deposit, and neutralize the toxins. So if we split all these elements, we start to carefully look at the human biology, how the system functions. When you start with the first one, the water, when you look at the lungs, you know, 90% water, the blood, the brain, you know, muscles, the bones, and the entire human body is made up of 75% water. So Dr. Bertrand Gelig is a great American scientist. He was trained by Alexander Fleming. He was a medical doctor, but himself, he said, you are not sick, you are thirsty. Do not treat thirst with medication. So he believed that medication may not solve the root cause of a problem of a disease, but just only the symptom, but may be due to the chemical presence, may do good, but may leave harm somewhere somehow. So go to the next is about oxygen. When you look carefully about the entire human body, the brain, the blood oxygen level, you know, the red blood cells, which transport, you know, the oxygen through the hemoglobin, everything is, when you look at carefully about the human body in terms of the oxygen, the entire human body's mass is composed of 65% water, I mean oxygen. But we believe that the Haqua revitalize infiltrate the body exclusively with 100% oxygen. That's what we believe, we hypothesize that. For the reasons that the atmosphere, if we have the best environment, we only get 21%. The balance is the nitrogen. So we don't breathe oxygen. That's the reason, I mean, wealthy people, they want to be near the sea because they feel more rejuvenated, more refreshing, because, you know, that's where the water cycle starts, you know. So carefully, when you look at Antoine Lavoisier in 1783, what he said, water is formed when oxygen burns hydrogen in the living system, releasing the energy that runs in our body. You know, so it means oxygen plus energy plus hydrogen equal water. Conversely, so water and is split through the energy. That's all. Energy and water. That's the reverse of the water cycle. Looking at the carbon cycle, everybody knows. I mean, many knows about. They know about the carbon cycle. Carefully, when you look about the sunlight, going by number 1, 2, 3, 4. So number 2 is that the sunlight which goes in the plant, which is the water in the plant, because of the sunlight, ultraviolet, produce heat, energy, cause the water to raise the temperature of the water. So to become hot water, you see here we talk about. So based on that, the water is added to carbohydrate because it's, it become energized water with the energy, means it's with the heat, heated water. And that added to the carbohydrate, and carbohydrate, I mean, to produce high carbohydrate, and carbohydrate are consumed by the animals, and they release carbon dioxide. And carbon dioxide, again, is split into the carbon and oxygen by the plants, and oxygen is released in the atmosphere. Whereas the fact is, Albert Zengiorgi, we'll talk about him very soon, he said actually the carbon cycle is actually the hydrogen cycle. Why? When you look carefully here, is that the sunlight, which produces heat, energy, the water in the plant. So what happens is that the water in the plant, when you look carefully, number 2 here, water is split into hydrogen and oxygen is released in the atmosphere, and hydrogen is added to the carbons to produce carbohydrates. So that's why he said actually the carbon cycle is actually hydrogen cycle. So when you take in the formula here, it means sunlight, which is energy, added to the water, caused to the split of the water and oxygen. I mean oxygen and hydrogen. So if you look carefully here, with the number 1, 2, 3, 4. So Haqua revitalized means when you start to infiltrate hot water to your body, what will happen here? If you realize that the hydrogen ions and hydroxide ions are split, that means the way that your body is infiltrated with hydrogen and oxygen. And in same principle, when you look carefully about the enzyme, what do the enzyme do? Enzyme, when you look on your left of your screen, enzyme, I mean, this is very important because of the metabolism. You know, all the food we eat, everything, are broken down by enzymes. So the proteins are broken down to produce amino acids. The fats are broken down to produce fatty acids. The carbohydrates are broken down to produce sugar. And I mean, glucose, sugar in the blood. In addition to that, the fatty acid, the glucose, the amino acids are broken down again to produce energy for the cells. So that's three functions. The fourth function, in addition to the amino acid to produce energy for the cells, it also helped to build up the muscles and the cells. So this is very important when we emphasize about the Haqua diet. We have formulated a new system called the Haqua diet. So too much of controversies about the carbohydrates, about the fats and all these things. These controversies, we believe that is because of the fuel. When the body is lack of the fuel, something goes wrong. Then we start to blame carbohydrate. We blame the fat. We blame and so on. No, it's different. There was a lot of controversy that first, it's not true that hydrogen, can be broken, in the water by oxygen or hydrogen through energy. When you look carefully from University of California, this study, they found that actually if you look carefully here, at 25 degrees Celsius, which is a room temperature, the water is at 7, the pH value, power of hydrogen, is 7. But when it reaches boiling point, it's 6.14. So does it mean it turned acidic? When you say 6.14, that means the more than 7.4, it's acidic, and less than 7.4 is alkaline. So but what did they found very interesting about the water exclusively is that as the temperature of the water increase, the pH decreases, yes, but it doesn't turn acidic for the reason, because of the hydrogen value and the hydroxide value, they increase simultaneously. And since the pH, you have only acidic when pH, power of hydrogen, is higher than the pOH, hydrogen ions. But because of the pH decrease, you have more vibrations in the water molecules, and with the pure water, which is the water that we drink, it's the drinking water, they found that the pH equivalent, it goes simultaneously with the pOH. So the value does not change, it remains neutral. Since it's neutral, then it's not acidic. It doesn't become acidic. Even the value is 6.14, water remains, healthy. I mean, it's not acidic. That's a very interesting, with the hydrogen, about Albert Zengiorgi, which we'll take again, we'll mention about him later on. He is a Nobel Prize winner, biochemist. What he said about the human body stores hydrogen is very important. Hydrogen in the liver, most of these organs, the largest with the liver and the least is the spleen and followed by others. And he found that as we grow older, this is very important, we grow older, we lose hydrogen, hydrogen depletion. But he didn't say where we get hydrogen. We discover hydrogen simply through from the fetal development, amniotic fluid, hot water. So you just need to maintain hot water. Nobody drinks hot water. You know, that's the problem. We create the problem to ourselves because we lose all these elements. And we know, science say that most of the atoms actually made up, 67% of the atom is made up of hydrogen. So Albert George, he got a Nobel Prize in his Nobel Prize winning speech. He said, actually, the hydrogen is the most powerful antioxidant. This is very important. Actually, when he died, he was having a research about the cancer and the antioxidant. Is it something to do with the free radical cells damage, which we'll mention later on? So what he, in his 1937 Nobel Prize, he said, actually, all living cells are made up, I mean, they need energy to function for the regular maintenance of the regular maintenance of the and the structure of the structure, and the body only knows one fuel, the hydrogen. Without the energy, the entire life will be extinguished, and the cellular fabric will collapse. So, since every matter is made up of atom, we are made up of cells. Cells are inside. I mean, the atom. Everything is made up, but the atom is made up of electrons, pair of electrons and neutrons. They are constant, completely with the same value. Now, what happens is that since we go through free radicals, you know, an electron loses its pair, it becomes impaired because it becomes radicalized. When it becomes a free radical, that, as you can see on your left of your screen, most of everything, all complications. So we call them diseases, but the fact is a dysfunction of the body. And when you talk about heart problems, you look at all these complications. You look at the kidneys, you look at the skin, look at the eyes, the lung, I mean, everything, multi-organs, the immune system, everything. So the moment we go sick, we go to the physician and we get diagnosed, we have a cancer, we have a diabetes, we have hypertension, it's actually the dysfunction. Even when you look at the CDC definition of a disease, there's no clear definition of a disease. It's just a dysfunction of the human body. That means it is something temporarily that's subject to be replaced. Since you're still alive, means you're still able to get back to normal state of your healthy state. But what we found, the depletion of this, since just only one atom, I mean one of these fields, the hydrogen, if you're depleted from hydrogen, what did they found? That because of the hydrogen is the most powerful antioxidant, it donates an electron to remain pair, because we become free radicals when an electron loses its partner. And you have a series of damage, and it's moving to the next cell, and series of multiple cells, and then that's where we get all these health complications. When we move to the third element, so we finish about water, then oxygen, now we move to the hydrogen, and now we move about energy. What does energy about our body? When you look at thermogenesis, it's for the generation and production of heat through a physiological process. That when you look at the laws of thermodynamics, like the first law about thermo, the energy cannot be created, cannot be destroyed. It's there in the environment to have. I mean, but with the thermo equilibrium, when you look carefully, the energy shifts from hot body to cold body, not from the other way around, until it becomes constant. You know. So here it's a very interesting. A calorie. So I claim that actually a calorie has been discovered by using hot water. Why? Let's look at the scientific definition of a calorie. A calorie here is the energy our body needs while increasing the temperature of 1 gram. So it's a droplet. 1 gram water from 14.5 to 15. So every 1 degree Celsius, every 1 gram is a 1 calorie. So every day we calculate how much food I eat because my body only can burn a specific amount of calorie. But did we think carefully, take one step to think that how calorie was the discovered. What is the definition of calorie? What is it related with what? We discover that it's directly linked with hot water. Let me grab a glass of hot water. I'm sorry about it because I'm addicted with hot water. Excuse me, what? Yeah. So a calorie is a direct. So here, why from 14.5? Why not from 0? Why not from 1? Why not from 5? Because water below 14.5 is below room temperature. It's becoming cold. Then you go against them, we can say the law of nature means a calorie with every increase of the water, with the increase of temperature, that's a calorie. So I can say here, exclusively, you burn your calories without any activity. Yes, enjoy your activity, but the exclusive, the essential means of burning calorie is through the hot water, is not through the activity. Activity is that's physiological activity or that you, but again, you become dehydrated, you lose water. That's why they say drink plenty of water. Here I say keep a haquet, not just only hydrate. When you look carefully here with the definition about the heat, when you add the heat in a system, you know, it either changes the internal energy or it causes the system to do work or both. So on the left side, you have on the screen, you have the hot water, 50 degrees that we recommend, 122 Fahrenheit. You can imagine when you imbibe with the therapeutic methods of drinking hot water, which is one modality, of course there are other modalities, you can imagine that the energy shifts naturally without any effort. So when you do exercise, you enjoy exercise, but the performance and the result will be much better when you maintain with the Haqua Vitalize and exercise more than just only drinking water. Or if you drink cold water, you are going against the laws of nature, say like the laws of thermodynamics and so on. This is part of the what we call, we coined it, the new system of the healthcare system, the diet system. We think about how much food we have to eat, what's the quality of the food, how much calorie we create, so stress to ourselves because we want to maintain our health. But the fact is, look careful here, between the left and the right, the food that we eat, as we mentioned, the proteins and fats and carbohydrates broken down, as we mentioned before, and all these, at the end, is just what? To produce energy. In addition, the amino acids is what? To build up the muscles. So since we need energy, that's the three functions of the food that we eat, irrespective of all the food that you eat. But you have a problem here. This is where I believe, I hypothesize, I could say maybe 90% of our dysfunction of our body, whether disease, whether in the physical, emotional, mental, and spiritual, any dysfunction is because of this. Toxic substances are not released, I mean, they're not excreted the way it's supposed to be. Because we eat, and these are piling up. And these are made up of these toxins. Carbon dioxide, methane, you know, hydrogen sulfate. They toxify, they destroy our cells every day. They cause the free radicals damage. Now, whereas with this haquet, when you haquet, there's not any toxins involved in the water. It's just plain drinking water. So with this energy and with the hydrogen and all these, they provide you a non-toxic substances. Energy, clean, the cleanest ever fuel energy you ever. So we go to the mental. So that what we've been talking about, the health is about the physical part. Now, if we go to the mental part, if you look carefully with the biology of a human body, mental part means our brain. That's where the mental, the function of our everything about mental is from our brain. The concentration, how you can increase your cognitive abilities, memory improvement. While we go through stress, that's something else. I don't want to talk too much about that because I need to abbreviate. The reason, when you look carefully, you need to fuel your nervous system. Look at what the biology says about the hydrogen, and I mean oxygen, water, and everything in the human brain. The human brain uses 20% oxygen. The human brain uses it's composed of 76 to 85% water. The human brain uses 20% oxygen, energy. When you look here carefully, 20% and 20%, that's the highest than any part of the body. Irrespective of that, our brain is just composed of 2% water. I mean, by weight, it's 2%. But by volume, it uses the highest. Highest oxygen it receives, and it uses highest energy, highest. So you can imagine we go through stress because the reason, root cause, is because we dehaquate. We lose energy, we lose water, we lose hydrogen, we lose all these elements. When you look carefully, they are transported through the circulatory system, the blood, and the blood is known to be hot, it's not cold, it's not warm. Breaking down all these lipids, it has to remain hot. And we know that plasma, blood plasma is made of 92% water. So I can say it's a river of hot water, you know, because it transports the oxygen and hydrogen and the proteins. And through when you do the hot water haquation, when you maintain the haqua vitalize, this is the most important, vasodilation. Because you need to maintain vasodilation, which is expansion, dilatation of the blood veins, to maintain the circulatory system, because if the circulatory system is affected, the entire system may collapse. I mean, again, that's where the dysfunction starts. This, what we talk, is the root cause of all this complication. The emotional part, which is very important, a lot of people go through this, like now we've been talking about the pandemic. No, come on, the pandemic, I believe, has come to bring opportunities. Loss may be temporarily, but the great achievement will be there. There are a lot of great people who are working hard, And it's always like that. The world is getting better by day and day. We live today better than our ancestors, better 20 years or 50 years, because there are a lot of great people who are working hard. And among you, many of you who are watching this, you are part of the contribution of this civilization that's taking place and technology.